President Obama making it clear that the wealthiest Americans should pay more taxes. He's also vowing to eliminate the Bush tax cuts yet again. But the top 25% of earners already pay 86% of the taxes in this country. So is the president's plan to cut the deficit just code for spread the wealth? He basically said if you ask rich people to pay more, they will. John Podhoretz is here. Art Laffer's here. Julie Roginski's here. Now, Arthur, we'll start with you. First off, the president, his theory, the rich should pay more. What would that do for the economy?
Well, I think the rich should pay more, but they should do it at lower tax rates. I mean, the one thing we know from all history is every time you raise tax rates on the rich, they pay less in taxes. Every single example of that. Now, that's not true of everyone else. It's really not. But this guy wants to raise tax rates so they get a bigger deficit, so they have less money to help the poor, the minorities, the disenfranchised. It's crazy, Brian. He knows it's better. He knows better. Anyone studying the statistics of income knows what I'm saying.
So what you're
is correct.
Saying is the rich will earn more.
Yes.
Therefore, they'll give more tax revenue back to
exactly.
the treasury.
Exactly. That's exactly what they'll do. And you can't balance the budget on the backs of the unemployed.
Right.
Julie, can't.
The president, that's where the president, where the rubber hit the road for Republicans, when he went out and said, yesterday, the tax rate should go up for the rich. They've had it too good for too long.
Well, the Republicans obviously want to, on the one hand, lower the deficit, but on the other hand, actually have no way to do it without raising taxes to some extent. I'm sorry, that's simple math. The Laffer curve is something I know. I'm a big fan of Art Laffer, but he and I disagree on this. I don't think it's something that actually raises revenue because what you have is a deficit. You ultimately lead to a deficit, no matter how many times you say that you're going to cut taxes and raise revenue, there's always a deficit. You had it with Reagan.
Well, yeah,
you
no,
have
but,
it
but,
with
but,
Bush.
But
you have it every time you lower taxes to this extent.
We raised huge amounts of extra revenues with the highest income groups under Reagan. They increased the amount of taxes they pay. It's the lower income groups that you lowered the tax rates on that we lost money on.
But what about the deficit that you guys
no,
came
but
up
the,
with?
The deficit is true, but here is an economy we need to get growing.
Right. But come on. The president is playing a very interesting game here. He ran in 2008 saying he was going to eliminate the Bush tax cuts. When push came to shove and the economy was in very deep trouble at the end of 2010 and he lost a big election, he ended up agreeing to their maintenance.
That's true.
And the real question that liberal Democrats have to ask themselves is, does he mean it? That is to say, if it's 2012, he wins in a squeaker election and it gets back to December 31st, 2012, and the economy is growing at 2%, is right. he really going to... Ray, is he really going to eliminate the Bush tax cuts and literally plunge the economy into a double dip
recession? That's
I
that
say
is
no.
It.
I say he doesn't do
so
it.
You say
and
he
Democrats,
doesn't do it. It's
I say he wouldn't
tactic.
Do it, and Democrats are foolish to believe that he would do it.
But to put it in context, it's something that Bill Clinton did back in 93 when the economy was not humming along nicely either. He did it. The economy recovered, and as Art says...
Oh, I think you want to bring in commentary on that.
Oh, well, yeah, but Clinton cut the capital gains tax. He cut government spending as a share of GDP by more than any president ever. I mean, he was phenomenal in this. The exact opposite of Barack Obama. I mean, anyone who compares Clinton with Obama doesn't understand politics or economics.
And you know
Clinton
what?
Clinton is a great president.
And Bill Clinton has a way of getting his message out. In some speech, in some place, he will let everybody know the difference between the two.